Hello student, today we will learn the type D chopper. Okay, so this is what? This is a two quadrant chopper. It functions in first and fourth quadrant. Output current is always positive and output voltage can be positive or negative. Okay, again it is also referred as a two quadrant class B chopper. So this is the basics of type D chopper. Okay. So it is a two quadrant chopper. Now we see the circuit of class D chopper. Okay, so here you can see this is the circuit of class D chopper. This one is the load. Two chopper we use here. Okay, S1, S2, and two diodes are used. Okay, now here the operation of class D chopper having two modes. First is the operation in first quadrant, that is in motoring mode, and second it is in the fourth quadrant, that is regenerative braking mode. Okay, so this is two quadrant operation. So you can see here, when it works in first quadrant, then output voltage is positive and output current is also positive. Okay, when it is working fourth quadrant, output current is positive and output voltage is negative. Okay, that means here the output voltage can be positive or negative, right? But the output current is always positive. Okay, so for motoring, what happens? Energy is travel from source to load. Okay, and for regenerative braking, it is travel from load to source. Okay, so this is the two quadrant operation. Now we see the first quadrant operation, that is in motoring mode. So here what happened? Two switches, that is two choppers S1 and S2, both are switch on simultaneously. Okay, so this is the required circuit for first quadrant operation. So here you can see switch S1 and S2 are closed, that is on, simultaneously. So load get connected to the supply voltage V. Okay, so here output voltage will be what? This V, that is voltage VDC. Okay, now one thing we will be clear here. So here you can see this is the positive direction. Okay, we assume this, we consider this as the positive direction of current or positive current. Okay, and voltage with this polarity, right, will be considered as a positive voltage. Okay, so you can see here in this first quadrant operation, the current flowing is from positive switch S1, then to load, then switch 2, and then negative current. Okay, so the direction of current flowing through the load is same as that of the assumed direction. Okay, so current is what? Current is positive here, and output voltage, this terminal will be positive. Positive will connected to the positive, and negative will connected to this negative. That means output voltage is also positive. Okay, so here, now here you can see the current is flowing through this inductance. So this inductor will store the energy with polarity, this positive and negative. Okay, so what happened here? Switch S1, S2 closed, right? This load will get connected to the DC supply, right? So the voltage across this load will be the supply voltage load. Current flowing in this direction, and that this is the positive direction of current. Voltage will be positive, and that is equal to supply voltage VDC. Okay, and load will store the energy with this given polarity, right? So this is first quadrant operation. Now we see the fourth quadrant operation, that is regenerative braking mode. Okay, so here we turn off the switch S1 and S2. Okay, as in first quadrant operation, inductor stored the energy. Okay, so when S1, S2 off, then what happened? Here, load will, that inductance will release the energy. Okay, with this polarity negative and positive. Due to that polarity, that D1, D2 will be forward bias. Okay, so here, when switch S1 and S2 are turned on, the load current continues to flow in the same direction. Okay, in the same direction through the load D1, D2 and due to energy stored in the inductor. Okay, now we can see here current flowing through the inductor again in the same direction. Okay, so output current will be positive. But you can see now this positive voltage V, this is V, supply voltage V, this positive terminal is connected to here and negative terminal is connected to here. So polarity is changed, that means here what happened? The output voltage is negative, that is equal to supply voltage VDC. So output voltage is negative, supply voltage that is equal to minus VDC. So this is the operation in fourth quadrant. Okay, so we can explain it by using the waveform. So these are the waveform for output voltage, that is load voltage and load current. So here when switch or chopper S1, S2 on, that is called the T on time. Okay, we are getting the output voltage positive. Okay, so in this output voltage, what happened? The current is increasing. Okay, so load current is increasing, right? As here load stored the energy, so load current is increasing. Okay, now here S1, S2 off, that is called the turn off time, and D1, D2 will be in forward bias and start conducting. Okay, but here the output voltage is equal to negative, so it is minus VDC, so output voltage is negative. Okay, now here the current direction is positive, but as the load, that is inductor, release the energy, so the current through the inductor will decreases, and so it is decreasing. Again here the operation will repeat itself. Okay, now here the average output voltage depends upon chopper on and chopper off time. Okay, so first is what is it? Average output voltage is depends upon chopper on and chopper off time. Okay, so first case, if T on time is greater than T off, right, then average output voltage is positive. So as we draw the waveform, so from waveform we can see average output voltage is positive when T on is greater than T off. Okay, so here you can see when T on is greater than T off, so output voltage, this is the output voltage positive and this is the negative output voltage. So when you take the average of this, then the average output voltage obviously will be positive. Okay, next is what? When T on time is less than T off time, then the average output voltage is negative. Okay, so when T on time is less than T off time, then average output voltage is negative. So again from the same waveform we can explain it. Okay, so here suppose, just consider, if T on time, suppose if T on time is less, okay, and T off time is less, then the average of both will be negative. Okay, and third case is what? T on time is equal to T off. Okay, so if T on is equal to T off, then if you take the average of this output voltage, then what happened? The average output voltage will be zero. So this is the third case. Third is what? When T1 is equal to T0, then average output voltage will be 0. So this is the working operation and waveforms of the class D chopper.